Good morning. In the last period we had seen an effraction through a straight surface. Today we are going to look at the refraction through curved surfaces. Suppose we have two solid spheres of glass and we fuse them together. We take only this part and this is our convex lens. The same two spheres, when kept slightly away from each other, and we fill this part up with glass, we have our concave lens. We will be using these two lenses for refraction through curved surfaces. But to understand that, we have one additional term to be learned, and that term is the optical center, which is denoted by O. If we take the convex lens and cut it vertically once and horizontally once, we get this point which is inside the lens, and this point is the optical center. Same way, when we take a concave lens, cut it vertically once and horizontally once, then this point here will be the optical center and will be denoted by O. Like we measured all distances in case of curved mirrors from the pole only, in case of lenses, we will be measuring all distances from the optical centers only. And hence, let us first of all tabulate the Cartesian sign convention. But before we do that, let us understand where the principal focus will be, so that our diagrams and Cartesian signs will be easier to understand. Let us take the case of the convex lens to begin with. We will have an optical center here. For this particular surface, our center of curvature will be somewhere here, and for this surface, our center of curvature will be somewhere here, and the line joining or passing through both the centers of curvature as well as the optical center will be our principal axis. And in case of lenses, we don't call optical center with C, we call it as 2F. Now it is very obvious that for this surface the 2F is here. What about this surface? The 2F will be somewhere here. Now we cannot use 2F on both sides, and therefore we say it is 2f1 and 2f2. Somewhere in the middle will be f1 and f2. Now we bring rays parallel to the principal axis to focus on to the lens, which is in this case convex lens. In this case, they will converge and meet on the principal focus on the other side of the lens. Now, taking this into consideration, if we say then the object will be on the negative x axis, and therefore u, the object distance, will be negative. The principal focus on the positive side, and therefore the focal length will be positive. The image will be formed here, therefore the V will also be positive, and because F is positive, R, which is 2F, will also be positive. Now we go for the concave lens. So this surface, the center of curvature will be somewhere here. For this surface, the center of curvature will be somewhere here, and therefore principal axis now, if we bring parallel rays of light to get incident on a concave lens, then they would diverge and go away from each other. On extending them backward, we will get the principal focus somewhere here for this surface and somewhere here for this surface. And therefore, now we take the Cartesian sine convention. For the concave lens, u obviously is on the negative side, and therefore negative. V is also on the negative side, so negative. Principal focus is negative, and therefore the radius of curvature will also be negative. Now, if you look at the first two tables of convex mirror and concave mirror, and these two tables of convex lens and concave lens, you will find that the object distance in every case is negative. Remember this, object distance will always be negative. Others may vary. Now we go for drawing ray diagrams, you already have the table for concave mirror. The same table is applicable in this case for convex lens. Remember, concave mirror table, convex lens table are the same. Slight change that you have to make in the table is replace C with 2F. That is the only change. All the other things remain the same. Again, while drawing the ray diagram, we will require 3 rays, 2 are compulsory, and for one, we have 3 options. The 2 rays compulsory, first is the principal axis, never forget to show your optical center and then draw the principal axis. So this is ray 1, ray 2, ray parallel to the principal axis. After refraction, it would pass through a point on the principal axis. The second compulsory ray. For ray 3, we have 3 options. The first ray passing through the optical center. It will pass straight through. Option number 2. Ray passing through the principal focus. This is option number 2, ray passing through the principal focus. After refraction will become parallel to the principal axis. And the option 3, ray passing through 2F. Impasse. Without changing the direction. These are the three options that we can take for the ray 3. Now let us draw the diagram for again the third position. Object on 2F. Image on 2F. We have the convex lens. The principal axis, the optical center, object on 2F. One compulsory ray we have already drawn. The second, as we know, is ray parallel to the principal axis on refraction would pass through the principal focus on the other side. The next ray that we draw, let us pass it through the principal focus on refraction. It will become parallel to the principal axis. They both meet here and we get the object on 2F but on the other side of the lens. The rest of the ray diagrams are already given in your textbooks. You may practice them. Matter of fact, that will be your homework for the day to begin with. There is one more term that we need to learn, and that term is magnification. What will be the size of the image as compared to the size of the object, and therefore it will be given as image height upon object height. Image height is symbolized by small h dash, and object height is denoted by h, and therefore mathematically magnification M will be equal to h dash upon h. However, we also can calculate magnification by V upon U. For lenses, for mirrors, this remains the same, but this changes to minus V upon U. Now in this case, this will be the object distance. This will be the image distance. This will be the focal length. This will be the radius of curvature. We know that V will be negative, U will be negative, V will be positive, F will be positive, R will be positive. However, the length formula is 2 upon r equal to 1 upon f equal to 1 upon v minus 1 upon v. This is the Lenz formula that we will be using to do our numericals on lenses, whether it be concave lens or convex lens. The formula doesn't change. Remember this. Now we will have to see the Cartesian sign conventional also for the height of the object and the height of the image and the height of the object. Now looking at our diagram, I will not be drawing all the rays. We know that the object will be somewhere here and the image will be somewhere here. We know that this distance will be equal to this distance. This is u, this is v. The image is real and inverted. Now if we look at the Cartesian sign convention, this height, the height of the object, is on plus y axis, and therefore height of the object h is always positive, whereas this, the height of the image, is on the negative y axis, and therefore for inverted images h dash will be negative. So whenever the image is real and inverted, the image height will be negative. Whenever the image is virtual and erect, the image height will be positive. So we say that this is for real inverted images, but h dash will be positive for virtual erect images. One more term you have to learn in this lenses, and that is the power of lens. The unit for power of lens is diopter and is represented by capital D. Diopter is always the reciprocal of focal length taken in meter remember focal length for all our numericals you will mostly find to be in centimeter, because we will be dealing with lenses with very small apertures. But to calculate the power, you will have to convert these centimeters into meters and only then calculate the diopter. This will give you one more clarity in our day-to-day life. What clarity? I am wearing specs. What is my number? My left eye is minus 0.25 and my right eye is minus 0.5. What does that mean? Refer back to our tables and we will know that convex lens, the focal length is positive, and for concave lens the focal length is negative. If the focal length is negative, it will directly mean that I am wearing concave lenses, because only the focal length of concave lenses is negative, and therefore the diopter, the power of my lens, left eye minus 0.25 diopter, right eye minus 0.5 diopter. Reading glasses, if you have elders in your house, they will be using reading glasses, and for these reading glasses the power of lens will always be positive, because reading glasses use convex lens. So for your homework, draw ray diagrams of lenses. Now this is for concave as well as convex lens. See you in the next video.